It's a good morning to all of you. So next, we continue on the tutorial file, tutorial 5, part 2. We'll be covered for the AC bridge, right? So starting on the question number 7. So before that, we already discussed about the tutorial 5, part 1, from question number 1 to question number 6, that we will cover for DC bridge, okay? So now we go for the part 2, will be on the AC bridge, okay? So we go for question number 7. Alright, so this is question number 7. Right, so you can read this one. Okay, question number 7. Right, so the question number 7 will be a balanced AC bridge have a following constant. Right, so the impedance, okay, the impedance for Z1 equals to 500, only the resistor, right? So maybe you can draw like this, okay, you can draw AC. Okay, for AC bridge. Okay, so this is we call it impedance, Z1. Okay, this is Z2 or Z3, depends if you want to refer to Z3 or Z. Okay, Z3 or Z2. Okay, so this one will be referred as the Z3 or Z. Okay. Then this one will be Z4, okay, right? So then from this one, okay, go to supply. Okay, so this one we have AC supply, right? 10 volt, 1 kilohertz, okay, 1 kilohertz, right? So the Z1 equals to R1, okay, 500 ohm. Okay, so the R2, okay, actually this is Z3, okay, this is Z3 because of they already given the point here, DC, alright, so this is Z2 lah. So Z2 equals to, okay, 1K, Z3. Okay, Z3 is equals to Y3 lah. It's a capacitor, because of this one given 1 over impedance is equals to J omega 0.2 micro. Okay, and then Z4 or Zx, okay, it's not given, we have to find okay, and then we have to sketch, then calculate the unknown constant Zx here or Z4. So the at the balance is before this similar like a DC bridge at the balance. Okay, Z1 over Z2, Z2 over Z4 or Zx. Okay, so Zx equals to Z2. Z2 multiplied by Z3 divided by Z1. Okay, so substitute the value, right? So 1000 micro ohms, okay, divided by 500, okay, 500 ohms multiplied by 0.2 micro. So the answer will be 0.4 micro. Okay, that's it for that. With the Z4 lah. Okay, so next we proceed for the question number 8. Okay, question number 8. I'll copy first. Alright. So this is question number 8. So the AC bridge in the figure 6 is a balanced frequency 1 kilohertz. Okay, and have the following component. That one is the pure capacitor. Okay, you can see this one, pure capacitor. Z2 500. Okay, this one. So this one give you the capacitor C1 0.2 micro. Okay, Z2 is the 500 ohms, and then Z3 will be okay series. Okay, this one. Like this one, capacitor. Okay, R3 and C3. Yeah. Okay, so R3 equals to 300 and C3 equals to 0.1 micro. Okay, and ZX is the okay. So the ZX and series adder. Okay, that's when they have the you have to calculate. So okay, adder series with inductor or capacitor with capacitor. So at the one right, so this is Rx is a Lx Rx Cx at the one or at the series with inductor or series with capacitor. So we have to find the value of Z1, Z2, Z3 in the polar form and obtain the value of Rx and Lx or Cx either this one it will be Lx or Cx, okay, inductor or capacitor lah. Okay, so first Z1 because of series capacitor 1 over J omega C, right, C1 is equal to negative 1 over 2 pi F, okay, 0.2 micro, okay, right, then that J 795.77 ohm. Okay, this is for Z1. Then convert into the polar form will be 575.77. Okay, the angle is the 90 degrees. Okay, negative 90 degrees. So this one you can calculate. Okay, this one you can use the calculator to get rectangular form to polar form. This one we call the polar form lah. So this is magnitude and this is angle, right? So the Z2 equal to R2 equal to 500 ohm, right? Okay, 500 ohm. And then we have the Z3, okay, R3 plus 1 over J omega C2. Okay, and then this is 300. Okay, the R3 is 300 minus 1.55 ohm. Okay, so similar like this one, similar like this one. How to get this 1591 from similar like 1 over 2 pi f multiplied by 0.1 for C3. Okay, so we convert into the polar form 1690.96 negative 79.3 degrees. Okay, so this is an example, and then Z4 equals to Rx. Okay, either plus minus depends. Okay, we assume as J X. Okay, X4 lah. So either this one will be, if we're positive, okay, will be inductor. Okay, if negative will be capacitor. Alright, so if this one the indicator this one. Okay, so first, okay, we have to go for the balance. Okay, so the balance Z1, Z4 equals to Z2, Z3. Okay, so we want to find Z4 or Zx here, right? Is your Zx here, okay, Z2 multiplied by Z3 divided by Z1. Okay, just and then substitute the all the value lah, 500, okay, 300 minus J 1.55 divided by negative J 75.55. okay, then simplify. Okay, J 7 9 5 7 8 kilo Oops, divide by 395.77. Okay, and then calculate using your calculator, you get 1000 plus 311. Okay, for one. Right. So you can see this one is the sign is a positive, so that means the series of for Rx with Lx because of the this sign is the positive. Okay, if negative, that means it will be series with capacitor. So from this one, okay, you can get R4 equals to 1000 and X4 will be 188.41. All right. Okay. So you want to find the value for this one for X 1000, and then for X. Okay, X4 will be 1.4. So to find the L4 because of positive, so we want to find L4 using the formula. Okay. 1 divided by 2 pi f. Okay. 2 pi f equals to, okay, you can use your calculator, 29.98 millihenry, right? Almost to 30 millihenry. Okay. Almost 30 millihenry. This is the value for L4. Okay, that means this Z4, okay, Z4 will be this one, maybe this one, Rx series with Lx because of this one, after you get the Zx here, impedance here, so automatically the sign will be represent the component, so if positive, so will be series with inductance, if the negative will be, for example, you got here negative, so will be series with capacitor. Okay, right, so here's all for the question number 8. Then we can proceed for the question number 9. Okay, question number 9. Okay, open the file first. Okay, and then I will copy the figure first, for the question first. Okay, this is question number 9. Question number 9. An alternating current AC bridge is a balance at 1 kilohertz and following components. Okay, so 2.5 kilo resistor in the arm AB, and then 2.3 kilo resistor in series with 2.14 microfarad capacitor in of BC. Okay, and then 100K is the resistor in the DA. Okay. Right, and then unknown impedance. Okay, so actually this is question number this is number 9. Number 9 already took number 10. So this one number 10. So we focus this one. So unknown impedance resistor parallel with capacitor. Okay, so we know this impedance for unknown impedance resistor parallel with capacitor. So the supply is connected across the arm A and C, and the governmental across the B and D. Okay, draw the labels. Okay, draw and label the circuit diagram, then determine the unknown impedance. We have to calculate the Rx and Cx. Okay, first you have to draw. Okay, for this is for question number 9. Question 9. Okay, first we have to draw. Okay, so this is supply. Okay, you can put as the Z1. It's okay. So you can put as the Z2, up to you. This is a Z3, and this one is the Z4 lah. Okay, so this one, then this one go for the supply lah, and then you have to put the value lah. So frequency is 1 kilohertz. Okay, and you can indicate here Z1 equal to R1 equals to given here 2.5 kilo ohm. Okay, Z2 equals to R2 equals to 100. Okay, this is Z2, eh? Z2, this is Z3 lah. Okay, it's 100 kilo ohms, and then Z3, okay, series. Okay, Z3 series lah. Z3 series with. Okay, this mean R3 is a plus 1 J omega C. Alright, so equals to 2.3 kilo plus 1 over, or we substitute this one will be negative, okay, will be J, here will be 2 pi, okay, this one 2 pi F multiplied by C, so you can calculate using calculator, so to get 74.3, okay, so and then this one Z4. Okay, so we want to find Rx minus, eh, because of the capacitor. So we want to find J or XC lah. Okay, so that's all for this one. Okay, so you just draw, you put this one Z1, Z3, Z2 and Z4. Okay, and then after that, you have to calculate lah. You have to calculate the impedance here. Eh. So starting using the balance lah, okay, using the balance, okay, so Rx equal to J XC, okay, just straightforward, eh, from Z equal to Z, multiply Z2, 3, multiply Z2, Z1, eh, just straightforward using this one, X equal to X equals to XC, right, so R2, R3, R1. Okay, so it equals to 100K by 2.3K plus J 74.7, right, divided by 2.5 kilo. Alright, so use your calculator. Okay, 2.3 kilo minus J 74.37. Okay, right, so then 92K, that's J, 2,974.8. Okay, so you can convert this one. So this is rectangular, so you convert into the polar form. So this one, 92.05 kilo, and then the angle is 1.85 degrees. Okay, so from this one, as we know, the Rx equal to 92 kilo ohms, and the X4 or XC equals to 1 J omega XC, XX. So we want to find this one, so you can calculate, okay, using the calculator, then you can get the one. Okay, you can get lah. Okay, so this one 1 over pi f. Okay, 974.8. Okay, so the answer will be. Okay, you can use your calculator to get the answer. What is the answer of this one? Okay, so around 93.5 nano. Okay, you have to double check that, is it correct or not, right? This is based on the schema. All right, so cool. So these are the Rx and this is Cx, huh? Okay, this one you have to double check, eh? Double check what is the value for Cx and Rx. Okay, next we go for the question number 10. Okay, question number 10. Okay, question number 10 here, eh? Given the similar bridge, angle bridge of the figure 7, okay, derive the equation of Rx and Cx at balance and then determine the value lah. So, okay, so you have to find this one lah, this part, eh? Okay, so the first, so just straightforward, maybe we can start from balance equation. civilian. Okay, so we can start from zx equal to z2, z3, z1. Okay, the sensitivity of value 50.3k. Okay, 2.5k minus j 15.9. Okay, divide by okay 1.5k. All right, so 223.18k negative j 147.44 ohms. Okay, so this is the impedance for zx, and then from this one we know that what is the rx, and the rx is 23.14 kilo, and then the x go to 147.44 ohms, and then you can calculate the 1 over omega cx equals to 147.44, so cx equals to 1.1 microfarad. Okay, so the cx is the 1.1, and then the rx is 23.18 kilo. Okay, all right, so so that's all for question number 10. Okay, and then we go for the last, okay, for the last question, for question number 11 for tutorials, okay, tutorial 5. All right, so this is question 11, for tutorial 5. Okay, for AC, for AC bridge. Okay, given the opposite angle bridge, okay, this is the Hay bridge as the figure 8. Okay, derive the equation, then find the equivalent series resistance and inductance Rx and Lx here. Okay, at balance. So, okay, so just straightforward. So you have, you know that every component given here. So we just straightforward, straight for the at balance. At balance equation. Okay, at balance equation. Zx equal to z2 multiplied by z3 divided by z1. All right, so then zx equals to rx plus jxl, I put sl, okay, plus r3 divided by r1 jxc, okay, xc. Then we can multiply, we can multiply, maybe you can multiply this one, the cross multiply, okay, or to do one equation, so you can multiply this one, so will be and then you can do, and then you can simplify, so this one already simplified for you, r2 r3 r1, okay, plus g xc R2, R3, okay, you have to double check, so this one already simple, so this one you can multiply here, alright, so and then just multiply R1, Rx, and then so on, okay, R2, Xc, R2, so, and then we can compare, we can compare imaginary and real, okay, so the real part, Rx equals to R2, three divided by r1 divided by power of 2 plus x power of 2, okay, this is xc, okay, and then you can simplify this one or just substitute the, okay, the formula, all right, for example you can, this one we can convert into R2, R3, R1, okay, plus R1 power of 2, 1 over omega C1 power of 2. Okay, so then you can simplify this one to get the omega power of 2, R1, R2, okay, R3, C1 power of 2 divided by 1 plus omega 2, okay, R1 power of 2, C1 power 2. So this one you can refer to the notes, how this equation get from this derivation to get this one. Right? So you can refer to that, to the notes, to the note. And then substitute the value lah. Substitute the value for omega. So omega is 2 pi f. Okay, f already given here. Okay, R1 is equal to this one, 1 kilo. And then R2 is 100 and so on. So the answer will be 9.75 ohms. Okay, that is for Rx. Then we have to compare for imaginary. Okay, this part for real. And then we have to compare for real imaginary part is the SL equals to XC R2 R3. This is R3. Okay, R1 power of 2, XC power of 2. So just substitute the value here. Okay, or you want to simplify. Okay, simplify for the this one, XC1. Okay, R3, R2. Okay, negative R2 power of 2 plus 1 over omega C. Okay, power of 2. And then simplify this one. Okay, we can get omega Lx equals to omega power of 2 R2 R3 RC1 divided by 1 plus omega 2 R1 power of 2 C1 power of 2. Okay, and then Lx equals to R2 multiply R3 C1 divided by 1 plus omega power of 2 R1 power of 2 and C1 power of 2. Okay, and then substitute the value lah. Substitute the value for R2, R3 and so on. Okay, for example, 100 multiplied by 100. Okay, divided by 1 micro divided by 1 plus 2 pi F. F is the 1 kilo. Okay, 1 kilo multiply power of 2. Okay, multiply 1 kilo power of 2. And C1 is 1 micro power of 2. Okay, so you can use your calculator. Then to get the answer will be 247 micro Henry. Okay, this is for Lx. Okay, so we get this one. The Rx and the Lx lah. Okay, so okay, right. So that's all for okay, that's all for tutorial. Okay, that's for tutorial 5, question number 11. Okay, right. So we already finished cover for the tutorial 5. Okay, for the part 2. Part 1 will be on the DC. Okay, part 2 will be on the AC bridge. Okay, right, so thank you very much. Okay, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.